Okay, students, so now let's move ahead to chapter 5, that is natural vegetation and wildlife. First, we'll talk about the natural vegetation of India. It is divided into various types, that is evergreen forest, deciduous forest, thorny shrubs, Himalayan forest and coastal forest. To start with, the first is evergreen forest, which receives more than 2000 mm of rainfall. The type of leaves that are found here are broad and green. The type of wood is hard, it is heavy and durable. The names of trees that are present here are mahogany, rosewood, rubber, etc. So remember, whenever you are writing examples, you have to write at least 2 to 3. Also understand the fact that evergreen forest ka jo trees hai, like mahogany hai, rosewood hai, to jo India mein hai, wahi Brazil mein bhi rahega. बहुत कुछ अलग बहुत कुछ डिफरेंट नहीं है. सेम टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रीज आर प्रेजेंट एट बोथ द प्लेसेस. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ इट इज एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट. नेक्स्ट टाइप इज डेसिडियस फॉरेस्ट. सो डेसिडियस फॉरेस्ट रिक्वायर्स अ रेनफॉल ऑफ 1000 टू 2000 mm. द सीजंस दैट इज द ड्राई सीजन, बेसिकली द समर सीजन इज व्हेन द trees that are present in deciduous forest shade their leaves so as to avoid evaporation. We know that evaporation takes place during summer season from the leaves. So they simply drop the leaves so that evaporation na ho. The types of trees that are present here are teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, etc. Understand one more thing, kids, because we are going to focus on scoring full marks here again. Aap kya kar sakte ho? Evergreen forest के बारे में जब हम बात कर रहे हैं, यू कैन ऑल्सो मेंशन द रीजन वेयर एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट इज फाउंड. सो यू कैन राइट अ स्टेटमेंट सेइंग दैट इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द वेस्टर्न घाट्स ऑफ महाराष्ट्र और इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द नॉर्थ और इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट इन आसाम रीजन वेयर देयर इज हैवी रेनफॉल. सो यू कैन मेंशन द रीजन एज वेल टू स्कोर अ प्लस पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट इज द थॉर्नी श्रब वेजिटेशन. So thorny shrub vegetation is where less than 500 mm of rainfall is received. The types of leaves here are small in size. Also, the types of vegetation that we find here are catechu, acacia, khejri, cactus, like aloe vera and agave. They both have medicinal properties which are present here. Thorny shrub vegetation is majorly found in Rajasthan Gujarat region and also in the leeward side of the western ghats. Matlab jo hamara jahan pe barish kam hoti hai, rain shadow area hai, wahan pe we can find this thorny shrub vegetation. Next we have is the Himalayan forest. The Himalayan forest is present altitude wise, so at the highest altitude we have seasonally flowering trees. At medium altitude we have coniferous trees, that is the trees which are in conical shape. At the foothills we have mixed forest, mix hai of coniferous and deciduous. We know deciduous is something that is present everywhere. So the types of trees that are found in Himalayan forests are pine, deodar, fir and sal. Finally we have the coastal forests. Coastal forests are basically the trees which are found in the areas where we have swamps, estuaries, lagoons, saline soils and moist climate. So basically wherever we have water property, there we'll find this coastal forest or coastal trees. The type of wood that they have is oily, it is light and durable. They are also called as mangroves or sundarbans. So the delta that is formed by river Ganga and Brahmaputra, that is Sundarban. Wahan pe jo trees hai, that is Sundari trees, these come under the coastal forest. The wildlife of India is as follows. So in the hot and humid region, we have the elephants. One horned rhinoceros is present in the swampy and marshy lands of Assam. Wild ass and camels are found in the arid lands, that is of Rajasthan and Gujarat. Snow leopards and yaks are definitely found in the snow-capped region of Himalayas. Indian bisons, deer, antelopes and monkeys are found in the whole of the peninsula region. India is the only country where we have both tigers and lions. Then we have crocodiles, turtles, gavials, which are found in rivers, estuaries, and the coastal areas. peacocks, Indian bustard, kingfishers, pheasants, ducks, parakeets, cranes, and pigeons are found in different forests and in the wetlands. When we talk about the wildlife of India, we don't just have these as a details given to us for our objectives, but we have a very important question from this chapter that is asked about the extinction of these wildlife, wherein you have to mention that the reason for the extinction of wildlife. So poaching hai, pollution hai, rapidly occurring deforestation hai, all this is the reason for extinction of wildlife that is happening. To safeguard this, we have a certain protection taken by our government. So protection of wildlife and forest is undertaken by our government in the form of building national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries, and biosphere reserves. Once again, when you're writing about this, you can mention a few national parks or wildlife sanctuaries if you know them by their proper names and if you know the region as well. Write the examples only and only if you are 100% sure of it. Koi gadbad nahi karni hai, likh rahe hai to properly likhna hai, nahi to nahi likhna hai. Next is Brazil's natural vegetation. So Brazil has this different types of forests, that is equatorial forest, tropical grasslands. Equatorial forest kahan pe hai? Jahan pe equator pass hota hai, wahan pe hai equatorial forest. Tropical grassland will come between equator to Tropic of Capricorn. Swampy lands are present in Pantanal. Hot deciduous forest is present in the rain shadow region of highlands. Thorny shrubs are present in drought quadrilateral. And temperate grasslands are present below the Tropic of Capricorn. Now, the point that we need to remember here is about the natural vegetation of Brazil. Unlike India, hame general information diya hai. India mein hame particular, peculiar information diya gaya hai about each type of forest. But here, we have been given general features. So, the amount of rainfall that is received in Brazil reduces as one goes away from the equator. Jaise aap equator se dur jaane lagte ho, waise the amount of rainfall keeps on reducing. The rainfall throughout the year is present in the evergreen forests, and during certain seasons, grasses, short shrubs, and thorny vegetation is found. During the rainfall season, you will find the growth of grasses and short shrubs. The names of trees, major trees that are found here are Pau Brazil, then we have rubber, mahogany, rosewood, and a variety of orchids. Amazon forests are said to be the lungs of the world, a very, very important give reason. We have to reason, we have to answer why Amazon forests are called the lungs of the world. Why is that so? Because it is a very dense forest. And we know the fact that trees inhale carbon dioxide and give out oxygen, because of which they are called the lungs of the world. Jaise maine shuruaat mein bataya tha, there are a few questions which have only two or three reasons when it comes to give reason. To jitna hai utna hi likhna hai. Isme aapko photosynthesis zabardasti likhna nahi hai na. Pura photosynthesis likh diya kyun? Kyunki ma'am 3 marks ke liye pucha tha. तो अननेसेसरी एग्जैजरेशन नहीं करना है, जितना आंसर है आपको उतना ही लिखना है. देन इज ब्राजील्स वाइल्ड लाइफ. इन ब्राजील वी हैव एनाकोंडास व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन द स्वैम्पी एरियाज ऑफ पैंटेनल. गिनी पिग्स, क्रोकोडाइल्स, एलिगेटर्स, मंकीज, पुमास, लेपर्ड्स, ऑल दीज आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट. स्वॉर्ड फिश इज फाउंड इन द सीज. पिंक डॉल्फिन्स एंड पिरानास आर प्रेजेंट इन द रिवर्स. Condors, parrots, macaws, and flamingos are present in the country. There are millions of insect varieties because we have a very dense forest. Definitely, we have a lot of insect variety. The reasons for degradation of environment in Brazil is illegal smuggling of wild animals. See, understand the fact that Brazil has a very dense forest. Itna dense forest hai, toh definitely wahan pe jo wildlife hai, bahut wide hai, bahut zyada variety hai, toh isliye wahan pe illegal smuggling of wild animals hota hai. Slash and burn agriculture, which is also called roca, is practiced here by the tribal people. Deforestation takes place on a large scale, and also pollution leads to degradation of environment. So again, this is a point that you have to mention when we talk about the extinction or degradation of natural vegetation and wildlife in both India and Brazil. So I'm sure that you are very much clear about chapter 5. Moving ahead, we'll talk about chapter 6, that is population. So India's population is 121 crores, whereas Brazil's population is 19 crores. According to the population ranking, India ranks second in the world. It has an area of 2.41%. Area-wise, India ranks seventh in the world. And the average population density of India is 382 persons per square kilometer. On the contrary, if we talk about Brazil, then Brazil, according to the population, ranks fifth in the world, although it has 5.6% of the total land area of the world. According to the area ranking, it ranks fifth in the world, and the average population density of Brazil is only 23 persons per square kilometer. This box, this information is very important to you from give reason point of view, where you have to explain or give reasons why India has less population, why India has more population density and Brazil has less population density. Phir aata hai the states with high population density in India. So in India, density is high in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Kerala, etc. It is low in Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Himachal Pradesh, etc. Why is that so? Because these regions are remote areas, they are inaccessible, mountainous region hai, heavy rainfall region hota hai, wahan pe nahi hota, extreme climatic condition. Population growth rate ki baat kare, to India's population growth rate is declining, but the population is growing. Population to badhte hi jayega na, multiplication to hoga hi, but the growth rate, the rate at which it was increasing, has now been coming down. Similarly, for Brazil, the highest population density is found in Sao Paulo, Minas Gerais, and Rio de Janeiro. Low population density is found in Para, Roraima, and Amazonas. Here also, the population growth rate is declining, but here even the population is not growing. इनका जो population है वो इतना कम है कि उसका multiplication is also very less. So it is negligible. So it is not even growing. Now, why did I tell you high population density states and low population density states? Because this is asked in map marking. Map marking में आपको question आएगा, mark any one state with low population density in Brazil. So in that case, you not just have to mark Amazonas, but you also need to name that state. Agar aap sirf wo jagah ko shade karoge and you will write number one, you will get zero. Aapko state ka naam bhi likhna hai aur aapko niche index mein bhi mention karna hai apne question, kaun se question ke liye answer kiya. Just shading a particular state will not give you marks. Similarly, if we talk about the composition of India, so India has more a proportion of youth in the country. Life expectancy in India is only 68 years. Literacy of India is 72.2% as to 2016 census. And the sex ratio of India is 940 females per 1,000 males. On the contrary, for Brazil, proportion of old population is more in the country. Average life expectancy is 75 years, literacy is 92.6%, and the sex ratio is 1,080 females per 1,000 males. Iska matlab Brazil mein sex ratio is high, whereas in India the sex ratio is low. Next we come to chapter 7, that is factors affecting human settlement. So factors that affect the human settlement ya to hamara decision as to kaha hame rehna hai are climatic factors. Hum extreme climatic conditions mein nahi reh sakte hai. Then is availability of water. Bhai pani to chahiye. Phir aata hai slope of land and then the level of development. Today you are living in a metropolitan city. All of a sudden main aapko kal bolu ki jaake gaon mein reh jaun, wahin pe rehna hai aapko. To aapke liye kafi zyada difficult hoga because you've been used to taking advantage of the facilities and utilities that are present in your region. So settlement in India is of two types, nucleated settlement and dispersed settlement. न्यूक्लिएटेड सेटलमेंट मतलब क्लस्टर, पास पास में रहते हैं वो सेटलमेंट. इट इज फाउंड इन द प्लेटो रीजन ऑफ नर्मदा रिवर, ऑल्सो इन द पैडी लैंड्स ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश एंड बिहार, विंध्या प्लेटो एंड अदर कल्टिवेटेड पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया. Now this makes common sense that wherever if you see the population is nucleated, that place receives heavy rainfall or it is near a river, and that is the reason we have more population. Also many a times like Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, because it is a flat region, वहाँ पे agriculture करना आसान होता है, इसीलिए वहाँ पे population ज़्यादा है. On the contrary, जो dispersed settlements है, they are found in the tribal parts of central India. It is in the eastern and southern Rajasthan where we have extreme climatic condition. Also on Himalayan slopes. क्यों? क्योंकि जो slope of land है वो uneven है. And finally, land that is dissected and has uneven topography. There we have dispersed settlement. In this chapter, we'll also talk about urbanization. So urbanization मतलब क्या होता है? Urbanization means the total percentage of population that lives in the urban areas. So India's urbanization is 31.2% according to 2011 census. Urbanization is more in the southern part of India than in the northern part, because we know in the northern part we have uneven topography, we have extreme climatic condition. Also in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Haryana, all these places we have फ्लैट लैंड वेयर एग्रीकल्चर कैन बी डेवलप्ड, इसीलिए वहां पे हमने अर्बनाइजेशन ज्यादा नहीं किया है. द मोस्ट अर्बनाइज स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया इज गोवा, इंपॉर्टेंट एज योर ऑब्जेक्टिव, ऑल्सो एज मार्किंग क्वेश्चन. द मोस्ट अर्बनाइज रीजन इज दिल्ली. अंडरस्टैंड ऑब्जेक्टिव में, एमसीक्यूज में कंफ्यूज करने के लिए आएगा. आपको पूछेंगे मोस्ट अर्बनाइज रीजन, तो रीजन होगा दिल्ली एंड स्टेट होगा गोवा. क्यों रीजन दिल्ली? क्योंकि दिल्ली इज नॉट अ स्टेट, इट इज अ यूनियन टेरिटरी. अदर अर्बनाइज स्टेट्स आर तमिलनाडु, महाराष्ट्र, गुजरात एक्सेट्रा, एंड लीस्ट अर्बनाइज आर हिमाचल प्रदेश, जम्मू कश्मीर, उत्तराखंड, बिहार, द प्लेसेस वेर वी हैव एक्सट्रीम क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशंस. After completing the human settlements of India, next we'll talk about the human settlement of Brazil. In Brazil as well, we'll be studying nucleated and dispersed settlement. So the southeast and the eastern coastal areas of Brazil are the nucleated types region where we have high population. Example, in the state of Sao Paulo, there we have good water supply. There is large range of natural resources. It is ideal condition for growing coffee. ये मैंने आपको पहले भी बताया था. Here we have major coffee growing regions or states. They have steady energy supply, good transport system, and the natural resources that is iron ore and other minerals are readily available here in abundance. The second type is dispersed settlement, where it is found in the northeast highlands. We have extreme droughts here. It is very difficult to practice agriculture here. The Amazon River basin of Brazil, we know, is covered by thick, dense equatorial forest, and this climate is unhealthy and unfit for people to live in. Also, there is limitation on use and exploitation of natural resource. Mera man kiya, maine Amazon mein jaake fishing kar li. Mera man kiya, maine Amazon forest tod diya. Aisa nahi chalta hai. There is limitation on use and exploitation. Because it is very dense and it is inaccessible, there are poor transport links here. About Brazil, we'll talk urbanization here as well. So urbanization of Brazil is 86%. India ka 32 tha, iska 86% hai. A rapid urbanization is found in the south and southeast region of Brazil, and the government here has been promoting go west policy. Why is that so? Because Brazil ka pura population concentrated hai in the south and southeast, which is leading to imbalance. And so they are promoting go west policy, where they can reduce this regional imbalance. The most urbanized states and the least urbanized states is what we saw previously as well. And we also know that they have been promoting the Go West policy. So this was all about kids, about your chapter 7. Next is chapter 8, that is economy and occupations. Here we'll first talk about the contribution of various sectors in the GDP of our country. So there are three sectors: primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. All these three sectors contribute in both the countries, that is India and Brazil. So if you look at the pie chart, you'll come to know that for India's GDP, primary sector in India's GDP, 17% is contributed by the primary sector. And in Brazil, only 5.5% is contributed by primary sector. For Brazil, tertiary sector contributes 67%. In India, 57% is contributed by tertiary sector. Looking at the pie chart, we can conclude that India is an agrarian economy, whereas Brazil is an industrial economy. Similarly, after understanding the contribution of sectors, let's understand what percentage of our population is engaged in these various sectors. So India's primary sector has highest population engaged. It is 48.8%, matlab nearly 50% of our population is still doing agriculture. Whereas Brazil mein tertiary sector has the highest percentage of population involved. And that is the reason we say that India is an agrarian economy. You will be asked this as a give reason question as well. Although we know that India's GDP is more, that is, it is around $2 trillion, even then, Brazil's per capita income is more than India. Why? Because we have bahut zyada kama bhi le to bhi, the population of India is high, but the population of Brazil is low, because of which per capita income increases. Phir aata hai occupation. In India, because we know ours is an agrarian economy, agriculture that is practiced in India is of subsistence type. Around 60% of India's land is under cultivation. Higher percentage, we know, higher percentage of population is engaged here. We have leveled plains, we have rich soil, cultivable land, and climatic variety, which leads to good crop. India also has mining. Chota Nagpur Plateau is called a storehouse of minerals. Agar aapne semi 1, semi 2, prelim 1, prelim 2 likha hai. Sorry, prelim 2 nahi likha hai, humne prelim 1. To ye jo humne exams likhe, usme hume pata hoga ki many a times we are asked to mark the storehouse of minerals and many of you make a mistake. So when it is asked, you have to mark Chota Nagpur Plateau and you have to write the name. Not just marking it is important, but you also have to write the name. The main occupation of people that live here in this region is mining. Coal mining is done in Korba in Chhattisgarh, that is in eastern Maharashtra, and mineral oils, oil wells are found in Digboi, Mumbai High, Kalol, and Koyali in Gujarat. Again, important for you to remember. Mineral oil and natural gas is found at the mouth of River Godavari. Marble is found in Rajasthan. Kadapa is found in Andhra Pradesh. Next, we'll talk about the fishing that is done in India. So India's coastline is about 7,500 kilometers and the fishing is divided into two, that is marine fishing and freshwater fishing. So marine fishing contributes to 40% of the annual production of India. This is practiced from Kutch to Malabar coast and Coromandel coast of India. The major fishes that are found here in India are sardines, mackerel, Bombay duck and prawns. Silver bellies, horse mackerels, clupids on eastern coast are also found here in India. The freshwater fishing contributes to the remaining 60% of the annual production. This is carried in rivers and canals, tanks, ponds, lakes, etc. The major fishes that are found here are silver bellies and carps. After fishing, next is industry. But before moving ahead, let me point one thing here that fishing of India and fishing of Brazil is a major question, very important question as for 4 marks. Matlab question number 7 answer in brief mein aapko distinguish between fishing of India and Brazil aata hai. To aapko very crisp, very nicely you have to present this answer. Okay, so make sure you know this answer very well. Then is industries. So India has metallurgy industry in the northeast, agro-based industry and cement industry, which is the raw material producing areas. में आपको ये industries मिलेंगी, जहां पे raw material produce होता है वहीं पे ये industries होंगी. फिर होती है forest based industries, which are also near the forest areas. Coir, copra and fish canning industries are in the coastal belt of Kerala. Salt manufacturing is done, or it is rather done more in Gujarat, Rajasthan and Tamil Nadu. Even this is important from our objective point of view and map marking ka point of view. Fir aati hai industries that are found here in India. So mechanical, engineering, electrical, automobile, fertilizer and consumer industries are here in the big cities. Refineries at Koyali, Digboi, Noonmati and Bongaigaon, close to petroleum producing areas are found. Refineries are also found at Mathura and Boroni, which are in the interior areas. Matlab sare jo hamare petroleum producing industries hoti hain, wo sari ki sari mineral oil wells ke paas nahi hain. They are also in the interior areas. Next is the trade that happens in India. So the items that are exported from India are tea, mangoes, coffee, spices, etc. And the things that we import are petroleum, machines, pearls, precious stones, and many other things. Trading partners of India are majorly UK, USA, Germany, Japan, China, Russia. We also need to understand the investment of Brazil in India. मतलब Brazil हमारे पास क्या investment कर रहा है, उसके क्या foreign investments है हमारे पास. तो they have invested in IT sector, they have invested in pharmaceutical companies, in energy, mining and agricultural business. That was about India's economy and occupations. Brazil. Now we'll talk about the agriculture and economy of Brazil. So let's continue with the economy and occupations of Brazil. Let's start with agriculture of Brazil. So the main occupation of people living in the highlands and in the coastal areas is agriculture. Why do they practice agriculture here? That is because they have favorable climate and good topography. The cereal crops grown here are rice and maize. The commercial crops are coffee, cocoa, etc. Largest export in Brazil is of coffee and soya bean. The major coffee growing states are Minas Gerais and Sao Paulo, which is asked at least 8 times out of 10 in map marking. And if not there, then one sentence में तो होता ही है. हमें major coffee growing states के बारे में पूछते हैं, या तो they ask us the commercial crops of Brazil, or they ask us the major crops of Brazil, where you have to answer the following. The fruits that are grown in Brazil are banana, oranges, etc. And we also have cattle and sheep rearing taking place in savanna grasslands. Mining in Brazil is done for iron ore, diamond and copper in the eastern part of Brazil. Mining is very, very well developed in highland region. The major industries in Brazil are iron and steel industry, automobile, chemical and cement making industries. The other industries found here are technology based industries, food processing, sugar, cotton, silk and woolen industries. Fishing in Brazil. Brazil has a coastline of 7,400 kilometers. It has marine and inland fishing both. Marine fishing, of course, is done in South Atlantic coast, and inland fishing is not very well developed. Even if it is practiced, old traditional methods are practiced. Major fishes found here are swordfish, shrimp, lobsters, sardines, etc. The trade that takes place here in Brazil, the items that are exported are iron ore, coffee, cocoa, cotton, soya bean, sugar, banana and oranges. The items that are imported in Brazil are machinery, chemical products, mineral oil, heavy vehicles, etc. Brazil's trading partners are Germany, USA, Canada, Italy, Argentina, Saudi Arabia, and India. Investment in India, matlab, the investment that Brazil has done in India is in automobiles, IT sector, mining, energy, biofuels, and footwear sector. And finally, the last chapter, that is tourism, transport, and communication. So in India, tourism has been developing of late. We have heritage, adventure, cultural, health, and business tourism. Tourism ke bare mein aapko history mein bhi hai, aapko geography mein bhi hai, and it is told to you very briefly, which are these different types of tourism. Ecotourism has been growing of late. Ecotourism is given boost now in our country. Tourism contributes relatively less in GDP, although the population that is engaged in tourism is high. Talking about the roadways, that is transport mein agar hum jaye to India has a dense network of roadways, and the density of roadways is high in the North Indian plains. Talking about railways as a major mode of transportation, then it covers very vast distances. If you have to travel for for your long distances, long routes ke liye jana hai, toh railways sabse best hai. But railways is very less in hilly states, in the northeastern states, central part of India, and in Rajasthan. Airways is developed more in India, and use of internal airways has been increasing. Matlab hum domestic flights ka jo rate hai, wo zyada badh raha hai, hum zyada usko use karne lage hain. Then is the waterways. Waterways contributes to only 1% of country's transportation. River Ganga is used for internal transport from Allahabad to Haldia, around 1,620 kilometers ke liye. Ocean routes contributes to 95% of India's foreign trade. Majorly apne ocean routes se hi hota hai, kyunki hum, we are covered by water from three sides, so it becomes easier. Then is transportation between islands and the rest of the country is also undertaken by the waterways. Communication in India. So we have explosion of electronic media, telecommunication, and it is growing very fast. India has been developing its own satellites, and it is taken care by ISRO, that is space launching programs are taken care by them. Talking about communication, we need to know the standard time and the time zones across the world. So we know that India is has a large longitudinal extent. So difference between the two extreme points of India is 2 hours, that is 120 minutes. So the extreme westernmost point of India is Guarmoto, and easternmost is Kibittu village. In India, there is only one standard time zone, that is IST, Indian Standard Time Zone, which is 5 hours, 30 minutes ahead of Greenwich Mean Time. The longitude, that is IST, is 82 degree 30 minutes east, which passes through Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh. That was about India. Next, we'll talk about the tourism of Brazil. So, it is an important economic activity in several regions of Brazil, because Brazil is very beautifully blessed with clean white sand beaches, attractive sea coast, beautiful island, orchids, etc. Also, ecotourism has been developing at a fast rate here because they have dense vegetation. Tourism contributes more in GDP, although their population, which is engaged here, is very low. Roadways. Most common method of transportation in Brazil is roadways, and the density is very high in the eastern part, jahan pe population concentrated hai. Railways is very less developed here. It is not developed definitely in the Amazon and in the swampy lands of north and northwestern parts of Brazil. Contribution of airways is very less here in Brazil. Also, when we talk about waterways, it is not very much developed in Brazil because of the rigid topography and huge discharge of water. Not aisa nahi hai ki uska sirf topography uneven hai, but if we talk about river Amazon, then the discharge of water is too much. Usme waterways करना बहुत ज्यादा डिफिकल्ट हो जाता है. ऑल दो इट इज द लॉन्गेस्ट वाटर वे, इट इज पॉसिबल टू प्लाई फ्रॉम इक्विटोस इन पेरू टू द माउथ ऑफ रिवर एमेजोन. आप वहां पे यू कैन गो अराउंड, यू कैन कंप्लीट द होल वे, बट डूइंग दैट रेगुलरली बिकम्स डिफिकल्ट. रिवर एमेजोन इज यूज्ड फॉर नेविगेशन बिटवीन डिफरेंट कंट्रीज एज वेल. And coastal shipping is practiced in the coastal areas. मतलब जो अपना eastern coast है, जिसको हम southern coast भी बोल सकते हैं, वहाँ पे coastal shipping होता है. Then is Brazil's communication. So telecommunication is very well developed and efficient here in Brazil. Developing technology to send domestically made satellites into space has been started here. Their Brazilian space agency, that is AEB, looks after the space launching programs. The standard time and time zones of Brazil, if we talk about Brazil, Brazil has a 4 time zones. That is because it is a vast longitudinal extent, the difference between two extreme points is 168 minutes, matlab 2 hours 48 minutes ka difference hai. So the extreme western point is Nassen do Rio Mo, which is very important from your map marking point of view, and extreme eastern point is Ponto di Sia, which is the easternmost point. Ye bhi aapko yaad rakhna hai, with spellings aapko likhne aana chahiye. There are 4 time zones, that is -2, -3, -4, -5. Maine -Q bola because they are behind GMT. You can simply write 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours and 5 hours behind GMT. The official Brazilian time, matlab if you living in India have to trade about anything in Brazil, then you have to follow only one official Brazilian time, that is BRT, which is 3 hours behind GMT. So class, that is it about our complete revision of 9 chapters. Next, we'll very briefly go through graphs. So graphs mein, you'll be asked questions like simple bar graph and multiple bar graph. So simple bar graph is something that we know how to make, but when we are asked about multiple bar graph, this is how our graph should look like. First, you need to write the heading and the title. You need to draw your x-axis, y-axis and make the markings accordingly. You also have to write what is denoted on x-axis and what is denoted on the y-axis. वो करने के बाद आपको लिखना है आपका स्केल. बिकॉज इट इज अ मल्टीपल बार ग्राफ, आई ऑल्सो हैव टू मेक माई लेजेंड. सो यू हैव टू मेक योर लेजेंड ऑल्सो अकॉर्डिंगली. वेन एवर यू आर मेकिंग अ मल्टीपल बार ग्राफ, मेक श्योर दैट वन बार इज एटलीस्ट 1 सेंटीमीटर ब्रॉड. 1 सेंटीमीटर से छोटा नहीं करना है. 1 सेंटीमीटर मतलब 1 बॉक्स, जो बड़ा वाला बॉक्स होता है, दैट 1 बॉक्स एटलीस्ट उतना करना है आपको. Keep one box empty and the other one you can shade it. पूरा डार्क शेड नहीं करना है पेपर, उसको टेयर नहीं करना है. इफ यू थिंक यू आर नॉट एबल टू शेड इट, यू डोंट हैव टाइम और इट विल लुक मेसी, यू कैन यूज अ स्केल एंड यू कैन ड्रॉ लाइन्स. बट वॉट एवर यू आर डूइंग, यू हैव टू शो दैट इन द लेजेंड. फिर आता है सिंपल लाइन ग्राफ और पॉली लाइन ग्राफ. So simple line graph means you just have to make sure that you're jotting dots and you're joining that dots with a line. That becomes your simple line graph. But polyline graph jo hota hai, wo aise dikhta hai jahan pe there are multiple lines. Now can you jot down a mistake here? Ki yahan pe jo title hai, usme simple line graph likha hai. Agar aapne bhi aisa mistake kiya, to aapka jo graph hai, pura wrong ho jayega. So you have to again write your title, your heading. स्केल लिखना है, लेजेंड लिखना है, एक्स एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस एंड यू हैव टू डू इट. ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड वन थिंग, यू हैव टू जस्ट मेक डॉट्स, कोऑर्डिनेट्स नहीं बनाने, डॉट बना के उसको सर्कल नहीं करना है. यू जस्ट हैव टू मेक डॉट्स व्हेन यू आर डूइंग दिस ग्राफ्स. हियर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू अ स्मॉल एक्टिविटी वेर यू हैव टू सिंपली गेस द स्केल दैट यू विल टेक हियर. सो लुकिंग एट दिस, वी हैव टू ड्रॉ सिंपल लाइन ग्राफ. वॉट डू यू थिंक विल बी योर scale here. So to guess the scale, you have to look on the right hand side of the table, that is number of female per 1000 males. Wo number ko dekhna hai, lowest and highest dekhe you have to write what will be your scale. So the scale here is 20 females. Again, we have a multiple and polyline graph given here. You have to look at both the tables, look at the highest and the lowest number, and accordingly, you have to find out your scale, which is given here as 1000. You can also consider it as 500. Now, here in this graph, you can see legend mein there are two different colors used, but you are not supposed to use color pens in board exams. So no using any other color pens, only pencils should be used. सिंपल बार ग्राफ है, आपको स्केल गेस करना है. आई विल सिंपली टेक अ स्केल ऑफ 25 मिलियन, क्योंकि नंबर क्या है, 50, 100, 150 एंड 200. तो मैं या तो 25 लूंगी, और अगर मुझे और सिंपल करना है तो मैं उसको 20 भी ले सकती हूँ. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, ऐसे भी मैं उसको डिविजन्स बना सकती हूँ. योर इट इज गिवन इन डेसिमल, सो डोंट कंफ्यूज योर सेल्फ कि अरे बापरे डेसिमल है कैसे समझेगा. Don't confuse yourself. Simply take your scale as 2% is equal to 1 centimeter. This is a compound bar graph. Compound bar graph is also called as percentage graph. So, yahan pe to